FI Vargas asks, why don't you make every single video with a tuxedo? How's it going? It's FamKam, and wow, 2 years today. 2 years today I started this channel, and I can't thank you FamKamians enough for what an incredible journey this has been, both here on YouTube and over on Twitch, and it's only gonna get better from here. So for my Channelversary, I decided to answer some questions in this video, and then after the this video, stream on Twitch to continue the celebration. So let's go through some questions. This first question comes from Mighty Drake Honest. How you doing, Drake? What is something that you learned in your 2 years of doing this that has helped you become a better content creator and a better person in general? I learned the importance of making meaningful connections with people. I was really, really shy when I started my channel. Not completely shy, like in IRL I wasn't so shy, but I was very shy on the internet because, you know, I was making friends with people who I didn't get to know in person. I had a very old school mindset. Nowadays, you know, we have to mingle online even with people we know in real life, but even so, that helps you become a better content creator in terms of growth. Networking is important, but it also makes you a better person in general because, you know, it's important to lift people up, lift people's spirits up. You know, we're in tough times right now, and, you know, for a lot of people, it's tough times, like, no matter what times we're in. And that's one of the beauties of ASMR is we're there to help people relax. We're out there to help better people's lives, you know, make people feel better, make people happy, you know, rid people of their anxiety, stuff like that. And it's part of the reason why I decided to become an ASMRist in the first place, because ASMR did so much for me. And I wanted to give back, and now having done this 2 years, it just feels phenomenal. This next question comes from Ronin, aka Katana Comet. Dream destination. I would say my dream destination out of places I haven't been would be Croatia or India or Morocco or Japan. I really want to go back to Italy. I went there about 11 years ago, and I felt at home because I grew up in wine country and in a very Tuscan-like environment. And when I went to Tuscany, it just felt like home in a different time zone. This next one comes from my roommate, Chad. What is the one thing that scared you most as a kid, and does it still scare you as an adult? As a kid, vampires scared the hell out of me. Like, any thought of vampires gave me nightmares. Which is why, confession time, I don't watch a lot of vampire roleplays in ASMR, because I got into ASMR primarily to help me sleep and to help me relax, rid me of anxiety, and vampires are not that for me at all. I understand why vampire roleplays are popular, but it's just not my cup of tea at all. And part of why I've had such an insomnia problem over the years is because I got nightmares all the time as a kid, and my body kind of protected me from nightmares by not letting me sleep in the first place. And vampires gave me nightmares so easily, so there you go. They don't scare me so much now, but I still have this instinct not to associate it with sleep. Sorry, everybody. This next question comes from Alpha. Why do you think pineapple should belong on pizza? I don't think it should belong on pizza. pizza if you want it on your pizza. Everybody has a right to put whatever frickin' toppings on their pizza that they choose. It's called freedom, folks. I swear I'm not getting political. I just don't like putting it that way. But what makes pizza good pizza is whatever you like on your pizza, not what other people decide for you. That's all. And he also asks, are you planning on getting new consoles or sticking with PC/Nintendo? So, a couple things about that. One, I don't just have Nintendo consoles. I have a Sega Genesis and Dreamcast and PS1 and 2. I am planning on getting the PS5 at some point, probably in a year or two when the price drops. I'm not going to get it at launch, but I am definitely excited about the PS5 nevertheless. Xbox Series X is really, really exciting too, but the problem is almost every game that I'm interested in on that console is also on PC. So I'm probably not going to get the Xbox Series X, but I encourage anybody else to get it if that's what they want, because it is a dope system, from what I hear anyway. More questions about pizza. This is from Dire Hit. Do you eat cold pizza? Do you prefer it hot? I love it cold and hot. I'm from California, and cold pizza is pretty popular here. Years ago, I had a roommate from New York who always thought it was insane when I had cold pizza. I'm sure some people in New York like cold pizza, but from my understanding, it's a lot more popular in California than it is in New York. But I don't know, I could be dead wrong about that. If you order a pineapple pizza, but you first pick off the pineapple, eat it, then bite the pizza where you picked the pineapple, so there isn't pineapple where you're biting, is it still a pineapple pizza? No. Because the pineapple is no longer there, just because there's like little bits of pineapple juice on it. I wouldn't call that a pineapple pizza just because it doesn't have the pineapple on it. I mean, if y'all want to consider it to be pineapple pizza, if it has bits of pineapple juice on it, go for it. I don't care. This next question is from Cristiano ASMR. Will there be a how to make ASMR mouth sounds like a tutorial someday? Share your wisdom with the masses, a wise one. I did that when my channel was still relatively new, before I even grew this beard. Link below in the description. He also asks, what is the best way to explain the virtues and good things ASMR can do to help improve others' stress management if they all have heard is bad info from unreliable sources? That's a really good question. So everybody I know personally knows I do ASMR, knows I listen to ASMR, and they're all, I shouldn't say all, but generally speaking, they're very supportive of it. The way I always explain it is I always come from the place that because of my terrible insomnia problem and problems with anxiety and focus and all that jazz, ASMR helps with all that, because everyone I know knows that I have terrible sleep patterns. I have terrible insomnia, and ASMR being a great sleep aid, letting them know that always puts them in the position of understanding that it is a very good thing, and also that I'm helping people with their sleep and their insomnia, their anxiety, and all that. So because of that, everybody I know is very supportive of me. Again, I probably shouldn't say everybody, but seemingly everybody I know is. Satisfactory ASMR Dad, aka Ness, asks, what is your favorite trigger to listen to and to make? If I had to pick one, it'd probably be Fluffy Mike. That was my first video, and my first Channelversary was done live with Fluffy Mike, and tonight I will be streaming Fluffy Mike ASMR on Twitch after the premiere. If you're watching this at the premiere, be sure to come over to my Twitch channel after the premiere. We'd love to see you there. Will Napoleon Dynamite and Snake make a return to your channel? Absolutely, especially Snake because of the beard. In fact, over on Twitch, if we hit 100 subscribers over there, I will do a live Solid Snake roleplay. You know what? Because you asked that, I'm gonna wear this in tonight's dream. So there you go. Kate Biddle, aka KB Cuddles ASMR, asks, what do you find the most sus? So, as some of you may know, recently I played Among Us with 9 other ASMRists, link down below in the description. I caught Sign ASMR getting out of bed, and then I walked in and found Dino ASMR's body, and there's no way out of that one because I later found out that Sign was the one who killed him, but he did go through the vent into that room, so the only way he could possibly be in there and leave is failing to report after he found it, or he was an imposter. Unless I was covering it up, but everybody voted him out, including himself, and it turned out he was the imposter. But anyway, speaking of which, I learned the other day that most people pronounce it Among Us. I've been pronouncing it Among Us all my life. I've been pronouncing that word Among, and I did notice that people were saying Among. I always heard people say Among too. What the hell's wrong with me? But I digress. She also asks, what is your favorite ASMR to do? Roleplay, singing ASMR, or gaming ASMR? I love all three, but if I had to pick one, I would say gaming ASMR. And the reason why is because, a couple reasons. Gaming is a huge passion in my life, but then again, so is doing impressions and singing. But also, gaming led me to ASMR. So, it's a special thing for me to do both at the same time. I understand that it's not as popular as role-playing. Like, everyone and their mother loves role-playing, and I love role-plays. I love doing role-plays, too. But gaming ASMR is my favorite ASMR category to do. That's why I do it the most, because I feel that if I'm making the content that I'm the most passionate about, people can feel it, too. So, there you go. Harmonious ASMR says, gotta add some here. One video game that is surprisingly ASMR, Zelda Breath of the Wild. I wouldn't consider many of the other Zelda games to be ASMR in nature. They can't work with ASMR. I've played the N64 Zelda games in ASMR, and I'm sure Link to the Past, Wind Waker, and Twilight Princess would be great for ASMR too. But Breath of the Wild seems to naturally fit ASMR very well. That's why I've done a lot of streams with it and will continue to do so. Most ASMR musical instrument in your experience, the harp, with the kalimba being a close second. You're stuck in a portal maze with one person. Who can best help you escape? Easy, Sleepy Kitty ASMR. She and I actually played Portal a few times, once on stream, way back in the day before the beard. By the way, side note, speaking of Sleepy Kitty ASMR, tomorrow is her Channelversary. She started her channel literally the day after I started mine, so be sure to check her out and show her some love. She deserves it. Zelda X River asks, what's your favorite type of ASMR? That's tough, because I like pretty much all kinds of ASMR, but if I had to pick one, I'd probably choose gaming. I love gaming, and I love watching Let's Plays, and I love ASMR, and gaming ASMR combines them, so win-win for me. Brandon Berteau, I think I said your name right, I'm not sure. I apologize if I didn't. He asks, what's the most time you ever put into a video game? Ooh, I want to say probably GoldenEye. I've unlocked every single cheat in that game the real way, not just with the button codes. I know every cheat has its button codes to unlock it, but also every level has a certain time frame to unlock a cheat within that level, and I've done them all. And that took a lot of time, needless to say, especially the invincibility cheat in the facility. You have to beat that level in 2 minutes, 10 seconds. I think it was 10. On 00 Agent, the hardest difficulty, and oh man, is it ridiculously hard to pull off, and that's only the second level in the game. Jay Hostetler asks, if you work for the company that makes LaCroix, what would you do? social media manager. I have experience in that professionally, and also I have a degree in computer graphics, so I'd be able to do graphic-related stuff with that. Selkie ASMR asks, favorite Nintendo game of all time? That would be a tie between Super Mario World, Link to the Past, and GoldenEye, which are my three favorite games of all time overall, and they're all Nintendo games. Well, I guess GoldenEye technically is a Nintendo game. It's made by Rare, but still, it's exclusively N64, and it's basically a Nintendo game, so I'm counting that. And last, but most certainly not least, Jordy ASMR. She asks, what are your favorite triggers? Fluffy Mike, as I stated, but also bubble wrap, sponge mic scratching. That's my number one trigger for tingles. Or bees. Squishy balls. Let me explain. There are these balls that have orbees in them that are like stress balls. And putting them against the ears on the 3DO is really good. Josh, aka James Bond 235, very well known ASMR streamer on Twitch, calls him Swishy Balls. Yeah, we just call him Swishy Balls. Terrible name, but amazing trigger. And of course, ear massage on the 3DO. I absolutely love that trigger. It's very soothing to me. It makes me feel like I'm like immersed in warm water when I hear it. What made you start your ASMR channel? So, as I stated before, this is a way for me to give back. ASMR has got me through a lot of hard times, and combining that with the fact that I've been doing film projects in general since I was 10, and I thought, you know what, I could use this passion combined with that other passion and do something with it. And I previously had a YouTube channel where it was a non-ASMR Let's Play channel called FamKam Gaming. It no longer exists. My Twitch channel, when I'm doing non-ASMR streams, is basically that now. But I wanted to give back in some way because ASMR has done so much for me. So starting my own channel was the perfect way to do it. Does your family know about your ASMR channel? And if they do, what do they think? Yeah, like I said, pretty much everyone I know knows I do ASMR and is very supportive about it, and that includes my family as well. My family pops into my Twitch streams every now and then and lurks, and then they text me later telling me what they thought about like certain parts of the flight. It's pretty funny, some of the things they say. For example, my sister saw me play Flight Simulator and she's like, so do you know how to pilot now? I don't even know how to pilot in Flight Simulator, let alone real life. Will you say LaCroix? You know why. Oh, I know why. All that being said, thank you all so much for your questions, and thank you all so much for supporting me these last 2 years. I am really looking forward for the next two, and the next two after that, and the next two after that. I would absolutely love to do this indefinitely, because ASMR is one of the greatest things that has ever happened in my life, and it's practically my life now. Well, I do other shit, but you get the point. Anyway, with that being said, if you're watching this at the